Yeah, maligaya ang pasko sa ating lahat. So, I am Neri. For the younger ones in the parish, they call me Ate Neri. For the older ones, they call me Neri Ganda. Yeah, probably because I am really beautiful. Or, shall I say, we all know that I see beauty despite all the circumstances. Amen. So, I'm sure you're familiar with me. You see me either with Maya or the youth group, or you can see me with Nini and Jesus with the young adults, or maybe once I served in the fellowship with you when you're not doing the hospitality ministry with Abby Jalinda. And you might see me reading during Mass, or you have received communion with me, as I did earlier, be like service to Christ the minister. You know, I face a lot of struggles in life, but one of my favorite verses in the Bible, and keep me moving, is the pain that you've been feeling can compare to the joy that's coming. That's from Romans chapter 8, verse 18. So it's one of my life verses. I'm so blessed that Epiphany has been my source of hope, for this is my family. I will never forget how lost I was in December of 2013. I was jobless and I was facing a major crisis in my life. I went to depression. Also, it was my first advent in the United States. I moved to California from the Philippines in May of 2013. So basically, I was still in the process of adjustment. During my first Advent season, in a place which is strange for me, and I considered to be a stranger, even my own family considered me as a stranger. I miss everything I left behind. I miss my own house, my loving family, my supportive friends, my amazing career as a college instructor, as a media practitioner. I had a radio show, a follow. I was a creative consultant for a local television show. I miss coordinating events for the entertainment industry. Particularly, it was Christmas season. I miss the parties in Fun Valley. I thought everything in San Francisco was very late, and not so Christmassy. I am from the Christmas capital of the Philippines, the home of the Pascuan village, and the home of the giant lantern festival, Bidin Parol. I came from Pampanga. So everything was tested. So when I came here, I find like everything was late. I miss my home. I felt like that was the saddest Christmas season I ever had. What I actually missed the most was my missionary life. As a missionary volunteer of Singles for Christ, I miss my life in service for others. I miss mentoring young minds and enlightening young souls to share Jesus with them. I miss traveling from different places to lead retreats and workshops for spiritual growth of different ministries. I miss working with the kids of Gawat Pilina and leading their faith formation. I miss my home, parish, where I served since I was 7 years old. In 2013, I have nothing to share. I live in my mom's family where I don't feel welcome. I don't have a job. I am all by myself. I feel worthless. The only thing I have was my spirituality. I kept my devotion to Our Lady of Perpetual Help, and I attended the Mass as often as I could. I was moved by the homily of Father Bill, our former biker, on one of the Sundays of Advent of 2013. He said, "We may not feel Christmas is coming because we are in so much pain, but Jesus is really coming to us. He will give us a home, for He is home." At that very moment, I felt the Holy Spirit move my heart, and I just surrendered all the burdens I am into. I got excited before the end of the Mass. They announced that the parish is no longer me. I usually intercede for something or for someone when I do the 9 days in Mondami. But on that day, I told myself, for the 23 days in Mondami, I will just ask the Lord where He will be leading me, where He wants me to be. I was able to complete the 9 days in Mondami with a heart filled with hope, with enlightened mind, empowered spirit, and nourished body. During that time, I don't have enough money to get myself a good meal. I usually eat crackers in school and drink water. I was very thankful that for 9 nights, I ate a good Filipino food. And for 9 nights, I felt I wasn't alone. I felt that the parish welcomed me and made me feel I was part of a family, the family of the Church of Epiphany. And suddenly, I heard the Lord whispering to me, "I want you to be here." I just cried and said, "Lord, lead me, help me, how can I be with you? Lead me what you want me to do." In October 2014, I was commissioned to be a parish lector and Eucharistic minister. And up to now, I am blessed to serve the Mass. It was very challenging to proclaim the Word of God and share Jesus. I believe in the saying that one should walk his talk to be true to his word. As a lecturer and Eucharistic minister, I share the Word of God and the body of Christ to our parishioners. The challenge is, I should be walking with Christ. You should be seeing Christ in me. I am not a perfect person, but I'm trying to be Jesus. The special man in my life always say, "I am too holy for him." I feel flattered that he sees holiness in me, meaning he sees Jesus in me. I always believe that when we serve in the Mass and in the other ministries in the parish, we are not highlighting ourselves. We share Christ to everyone. When we started the young adult ministry in 2015, it was four of us. It was just four of us. Maki, the son of Kuya, Ray, Jose, and Susan Yon, who just recently got married at the time. Under the supervision of Deacon Chico and his wife, Lee. It was not easy to form a ministry. There was time that the four of us doubted ourselves if we could form the young adult ministry of the Epiphany, or what we call the young man. We were moved when Deacon Chito highlighted in one of his, in our meeting, he said, "It will surely gonna be hard to visualize our vision if we are setting our mind at reforming an organization. But it will be easy if we set our mind that we are building a family of God. We will do it out of love and with hope." Praise God, 4 years later, with the help of Father Cameron, and of course the initiative of me, Jesus, and everybody. From the four members of YAMI, we became a growing family. Not only that, YAMI extended their service in different miracles, in different ministries. Deacon Chito and he had moved to Arizona. Father Cameron moved to a different service area. I might not be available in the future for YAMI, but I know that YAMI, or YAMI, will continue to share hope in the Church of the Epiphany. Even we are homeless, we need to be sources of hope. I became anxious with death when our neighbor was murdered in May, and his daughter killed him and embodied his remain. I know you heard this over the news. It's in the month. I fear that any time I would receive a call or a message that a family member in the Philippines died. My high school teacher died in June. After a few days, my friend in New Jersey died in a car accident. I was so depressed and anxious about it. I I cannot focus. I fear to hear another bell. Yet, my Papa Alan, my Uncle Alan, my God's younger brother, passed away last July 29th. After years of fighting cancer, and then 10 days after that, my grandmother, my dad's mom, passed away. I lost two of my best mentors in life. They both lead me the spiritual journey, a life of service and spiritual nourishment. I am still mourning. I cry every time I remember them. Recently, Father Eugene had a family member pass away. He went home to the Philippines. I asked if he's sad. He said, "Why would I be sad? They are now with the Lord. We should not be sad because they are with the Lord." I realized I should not be feeling hopeless, but I should be sharing joy. I divert my mind in service. They will remain in my heart as I serve because they were the one who inspired me to serve my brethren to part from the relation. My Papa Alan and Apo San lead me to the life of service. They also inspired me to teach values education because both of them are Catholics. My grandmother was the head of the information in our parish, San Nicolas de Tolentino Parish, and my uncle was the head of Christian life education for Colegio de San Lorenzo in Pampanga. I promised to myself that I would continue your legacy in sharing Christ by teaching Christ for the future of the church, the children of the youth. I am currently helping the youth formation in our parish, and I also teach confirmation classes. What gives you hope? I attended the Catholic Ministry Conference last December 7th. In one of the workshops, I was asked, "What gives you hope?" Right away, I answered, "The Eucharist gives me hope because Jesus is the Eucharist. And Jesus is hope." Brothers and sisters, what gives you hope? Thank you, everybody. May God bless you.